In the world of Hollywood, it's all about the drama, and perhaps the greatest compliment a filmmaker can receive is the knowledge that fans are going to leave the theater talking about their movie. But what happens when the discussions start to heat up? Over the past few years, audiences have watched all sorts of conflict play out on screen. Whether it's born out of genuine conversation or the flames being fanned by marketing people, sometimes picking a side is half the fun of watching a movie. And viewers don't have to go very far to find others' opinions either. Sometimes a quick scroll through the comments section is all it takes to start a war. Here are 10 movies that made fans choose sides. Batman vs. Superman: Dawn of Justice. Three Oscar winners have played big screen Batman at this point, and every new casting decision comes with its own round of outrage. Apparently, nobody can seem to get it quite right. So when it was revealed that Ben Affleck would be donning the cape and cowl in Zack Snyder's Batman vs. Superman: Dawn of Justice, the internet exploded and battle lines were drawn. But Affleck's casting was only the first of many hot debates surrounding the film. Right down to the poster, everything about the movie is designed to have audiences picking a side in the fight between Batman and Superman. After opening to very mixed reviews, it seems the actors are divided themselves, with Jeremy Irons recently speaking out in favor of the film's bad reviews, while other cast members remain mum. Chances are you have an opinion about some element of this movie, even if you haven't seen it. Inception. We've all heard the saying, perception is reality. And in 2010, director Christopher Nolan gave audiences yet another controversial ending to argue about. Viewers watch with anticipation as Cobb, played by Leonardo DiCaprio, spins a top. By paying attention to how the top behaves, the audience can keep track of where the characters are, in a dream or in reality. And after seemingly faltering, the movie fades to black. Fans have bantered amongst themselves about what it all means. Was the whole thing a dream? Did Cobb wake up? The director has acknowledged the ending's ambiguousness, but maintains that that's what makes it a powerful one. He's encouraged fans to pay less attention to the top and more attention to the fact that Cobb doesn't care if it falls over or not. If his surroundings feel real, then to him, they are real. The Twilight Saga: New Moon. In the mid to late 2000s, the decade-long war between vampires and werewolves came to a head, and all of us were casualties. The conflict affected millions of teens worldwide as they chose one of two teams, Team Edward or Team Jacob. Thanks to a clever marketing team, Twihards were able to pledge their allegiance with t-shirts, body pillows, and other crazy merchandise. The love triangle between Bella and her two mythical beast boyfriends is the main theme in the franchise's second installment, New Moon. After being ditched by Edward, Bella finds happiness in her friendship with the charming wolf-next-door type, Jacob. Some fans saw this as disloyal, and the rift was born. Whether you believe it's a testament to the power of advertising or a legitimate stance worth defending in a bumper sticker form, the Team Edward, Team Jacob drama really boils down to this: abs versus eyes. The Hunger Games. A boom in the success of books aimed at young adults led to a lot of big screen adaptations, and one of the most successful franchises to come out of this era is The Hunger Games. The story follows Katniss Everdeen, a young tribute representing her district in a competition that usually ends in death. Over the course of Katniss's adventure, we meet her lifelong friend Gale and fellow tribute Peeta, and watch her flip-flop between being in love with both of them. Fans of the books and movies alike have strong opinions on which one of them deserves to be the Mockingjay's bae. If you're still unsure whose side you're on, there are more than a few online quizzes that can help you figure that out. Man of Steel. Superman is known for many things, but chief among them is his moralistic approach to fighting crime. In 2013's Man of Steel, director Zack Snyder and writer David S. Goyer tackled the legendary character's origin story, and the response was mixed. The film was criticized for being all style and no substance, and all too reliant on its action scenes. But many fans of the character took issue with something else entirely: the ending. Instead of sending him back to the Phantom Zone, Superman kills General Zod, leading some fans to cry foul. The hero's history of taking the high road in all situations was completely overturned. Even though, as one screen ranter pointed out, Superman made the same decision all the way back in 1980's Superman 2. Iron Man 3. For many fans, seeing how an actor interprets a character is a nerve-wracking event. So when the Mandarin, played by Ben Kingsley, finally showed up in 2013's Iron Man 3, audiences braced for impact. Sir Ben Kingsley is a veteran actor who's used to the pressure of playing well-known characters, but he probably wasn't ready for the backlash his performance would cause. Some believe that director Shane Black's reimagining of the character as merely an oddball pawn was an insult to the character. Fans might have been willing to overlook some of the inconsistencies so long as they could see the Mandarin's 10 rings of power in action. But those were changed too, from rings into a network of terrorists. Talk about a bait and switch. Both the actor and director stand by the adaptation, but they might be the only ones. Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope. Since it was began in 1977, the Star Wars franchise has produced some of the most iconic moments in popular culture. Legions of fans, young and old, can quote every installment word for word, even the bad ones, Phantom Menace. And in a group with that kind of passion, canon is king. So when George Lucas went messing around with the editing of the cantina scene in A New Hope, people noticed. Some re-releases feature an alternate sequence of events in the showdown between Han Solo and Greedo. Many argue that with each edit, the director put Solo's character development in jeopardy. The fan reaction was so pronounced that it catapulted another phrase into infamy: Han shot first. Star Wars Episode 6, Return of the Jedi. It's safe to say that more than a few people were looking forward to see the next installment in George Lucas's saga, and fans couldn't wait to take another trip to the galaxy far, far away. Audiences were able to lose themselves in the elaborate settings while being amazed by the creative alien races being depicted on screen. But when the story took viewers to the forest moon of Endor, things got a little heated. Some pundits agree that the Ewoks added nothing to the storyline and instead acted as a marketing tool to sell toys. Others just found their appearance distracting, maintaining that there's no way something that cute could also be deadly. Whether you love them or hate them, the furry little fighters throw one heck of a barbecue. Casino Royale. Audiences have come to expect that the role of James Bond is going to be recast every couple of movies. Yet, when it happens, someone always gets offended. From Connery to Brosnan, casting for the iconic role has always generated lots of attention. When it was announced that Daniel Craig would be the next Bond, some opponents were quick to remind everyone that it's James Bond, not James Blonde. Beyond hair color, audiences were expecting a certain degree of goofiness from 007, and some Bond buffs took issue with Craig's drier, darker take on the character. But it seems that no one wants it to be over faster than Greg himself, who threw the entire junket for Spectre to the wolves, and declared his resentment at having to reprise his role as a super spy. One thing is for certain, whoever comes next has a big tuxedo to fill. Captain America Civil War. It seems like a fair fight is hard to find these days, and while many people enjoy comic book movies, others can't get past the blatant lack of superhero accountability, leveling entire cities and suffering no repercussions. Thankfully, Captain America and Iron Man are here to buck both of those big screen trends. In many ways, Civil Wars is a discussion about accountability. Told from both angles of an ideological rift, each team is worth rooting for. But everyone has a favorite Avenger, so naturally fans are choosing sides. The drama extends beyond the storyline, as some audience members have noticed more than a few parallel themes running between Civil War and Batman vs. Superman. And if the discussion dissolves into the tired Marvel vs. DC debate, the internet is bound to have its own Civil War in the comments section. Sometimes the most interesting arguments are the ones where everyone's right. What do you think of our list? Did we miss any other divisive movies? Tell us about your favorites in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one.